In this video, I teach you a root blower, its construction, working, equation of perturbance, applications and advantages. So it is also known as the root compressor. Okay. Now, in this image you see that it is known as a root or a lob. Okay. So that is, this image is indicating the three lob blowers and this image is indicating the two lob. So this part or this shape is known as the lobe. In some book it's denoted as a rotors, okay, and in some book it is denoted as a root. So this is the image of a root blowers. This is the front view and this is the side view of this image. So we understand its construction. The two lob type rotor blower is shown in this figure. So this is a two lob. This one is the one lob. This is the second lob. For a high pressure ratio, three or a four lob may be used. Okay. So instance of these two, that is a three lob is used. Three lob means its shape is changed, that is seen in this image. This is a one lob, this is a second lob and this is the third lob. And it is also one is added, then it is the four lob. But surface remains the two. This is a one shaft and this is the second shaft. The machine is consist of fixed casing which contain the two shaft fitted with the two lob rotors. So this outer body is known as the casing. And inside this casing, that is a root or a lob is installed. So one of the rotor is connected to external drive. External drive means it is the electric motor or either it is IC engines. So this one root is connected with a electric motor to run the lob. And the second rotor is driven from the first rotor by using the gear. Means this one is connected with electric motor. Then how to rotate the second shaft? So second shaft is run by using this gear mechanism. So in a side view you see that it is the external gear drive. Okay. So on this back side of this front view, that is a one gear is connected to drive the another root or a rotor. The air is drawn through an inlet pipe due to the rotations of the rotor. Means this is our inlet side. So when the rotor is start to rotate, the air from the atmosphere is come inside this casing. The volume of air is entrapped between the one rotor and casing for a very short intervals. Means the volume of air enter in a compressor is come between the one rotor and casing that we seen in the next image. Okay. And how the pressure of the air is increased. Okay. So means the air taken from this part is moving. Okay. From this region that we seen later on. Due to this rotation of lob, trapped air is carried to the discharge side, means air is entered from here, so with the lob it is moving and it's come on this discharge side. And continuous rotation of the rotor open the trap space to the discharge port. The air is pushed to the receiver, means it is the receiver where the air is stored. So air from this compressor is pushed, means the forces apply on the air and it is pushed to the receiver due to the continuous rotation of the rotor. To reduce the wear, a small clearance means 0.01 cm to 0.02 cm is provided between the lob and casing. So here you see that there is a slight space between the rotor and the casing. Okay, so it is provide for the reduce the wear. The clearance however forms a leakage part. This opening is provide the leakage, means compressed air is leaked from this clearance and has increased the adders effect on the efficiency as the pressure ratio is increased. Here I show you this another image. Before that I request to like the video and subscribe the channels by pressing the subscribe buttons. So on this image the air is entered from this side. Now here you see that is the air is between this one lob and this is the casing. Okay. Then further the rotation of the rotor, this air is entrapped between this casing and that. Okay. Means its slight pressure is increased. Here the next position is rotor is here or a root is there. Okay. Then again the new space and then after this air is discharged to the receiver from this side. So this process is continuously takes place. Means here the entrapped of the air is start at that time. Here you see that is a suction is also starting. Okay, so it is a one continuous process. Now, next is the equation of work done. For that, we draw the PV diagram. Okay, on the y-axis, it is the pressure. On the x-axis, it is the volume. So, when the suction is start, there is no air. Means volume of the air is zero. But pressure is certain above the zero atmospheric pressure and below the atmospheric pressure. So, here it is a zero pressure. Here the slight higher pressure. Okay, so it is the 0.0. So, initially volume is zero. So, this is the volume line is 0. When we moving right side, volume is increasing. So 0 volume, certain pressure. So, point number 1, 0 is come here. Then after suction is start, means at the constant pressure, volume of the air is increased inside the compressor. So, here volume is increased from V0 to V1. So, it is our point number 1. Then after compression of the air or gases takes place. And this compression is due to the irreversible pressure increase due to the backflow from the reservoir. Means pressure of the air or gas is increased due to the backflow of the air from the reservoir. Okay. Then after delivery start, during this delivery process, it is a isobaric, means constant pressure. And during the delivery, we supplied the air from the compressor. Means volume of the air is continuously reducing from this V2 to V3 or it's lead to the zero. Okay. So this is known as the delivery process. Now the area under this PV diagram is indicate the work done. So, in this area, what we seen, it is the rectangle. So, what is the work done? So, area of rectangle, that is equal to the work done. So, work done is equal to, what is the, this height? Height is P2 minus P1. This is the height of this rectangle. And what is the width? Width is the, this is the V1 minus V0. And it is equal to the Vs, means it is equal to the swept volume. So, it is multiplied with this S. This is the area of the rectangle. So it is our work done. So work done per cycle process is reversible area weighting, means isentropic process. So when this process is isentropic, at that time this equation is correct. Now what is the efficiency of this root blower? So efficiency is equal to work done isentropically divided by actual work done. So what is the work done isentropically? So this is the equation that we derive from a reciprocating compressor. That is gamma upon gamma minus 1 into P1 into Vs in bracket P2 upon P1 raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma minus 1 divided by actual work done. So this is the actual work done. And what is isentropic? That is used for a reciprocating compressor. This is the same. Okay. So these are the equation for a root blower efficiency. Next we understand its application. So first application is the scavenging and supercharging of the IC engine. So during this supercharging, we are required more power. At that time, the root blower is installed in a suction side of air. And scavenging is the use for the removing the exhaust air from a IC engine. So at that time, the root blower is started and the air is supplied in a IC engine. And that remove the exhaust gases from the engine. It is known as the scavenging. Second application is the delivery capacity is 0.14 meter cube per minute to 1400 meter cube per minute, and the pressure ratio is 2:1 for a single stage and a 3:1 for a two stage. Next is the advantages. It has only the two moving parts, means that is a two rotor, which are identically in shape and size. Its operation is entirely rotary, so due to there is a no vibrations and no need to the balancing. As the rotors are symmetrical about their center of rotation, the operation is dynamically balanced, and discharge of the compressed gas is complete and there is no clearance volume. So thank you for watching this video. If you learned and like the video, subscribe the channels and share with your friends.